Hey guys, so I'm gonna try this contouring thing with makeup. Y'all know I'm not like advanced on my makeup game. So I'm gonna try this contouring thing right now. So if I mess up, please don't talk about me. But I'm gonna try to do it, and why not my first time be with you all? So yeah, I'll show you everything that I use on the way, and we'll see how this thing works. So right now, only thing I have done is my brows, and yes, you can see the concealer on it. Don't sue me. I'm leaving it right there so that I can, you know, try this contouring thing. So let's get started. So I think I'll need some music because I don't know how long this will last. Shuffle. I don't know if y'all can hear this, but I can't. I'm gonna start with some Photo Perfect Primer from NYX. Just a little bit. So this is my cappuccino. I think this was by Maybelline. I need to get some more. Right now I'm just gonna cover up some blemishes, and I'll just sporadically put that places. And this is the same concealer that I use for my brows. Again, it's cappuccino Maybelline. Okay, now I'm going to get the foundation that I use, and this is Dream Liquid Mousse by Maybelline, and it looks like this. This is just one of these. Next, I am going to take the same concealer and place it on my face, and I don't know how this is going to go. So, I've seen people do it on the nose and come up and do it around this part. Again, y'all, don't sue me. Okay. Chin, lip, and I can't forget to do it around my eyes. Who's your mama? Just kidding. I have one of these sponge brushes, and these things are great for my foundation. As you can see, I've used it already for foundation. So I'm going to take one side and, you know, just go at it and start blending it down my nose. And I blend more once I get my contouring together. Okay, I just want to make sure this is together. And the reason why I did it on my nose like this, if some of y'all don't know that, don't partake in this type of makeup action, it's for the highlight on the nose. The nose usually has a natural highlight, but once you add concealer to it, it just makes it a little bit better. So make sure that you blend all the places that you put your concealer. And if you're listening to my music, if you can actually hear it, I do like older music. I don't usually like music when it first comes out. I like when it gets a little old. A little marinated music. Okay. So, it's blended. It's not all the way blended yet, but it is blended. So now I am going to get my, yeah, I think this is like my first real big MAC purchase, and don't talk about me, but it's the Studio Tech from MAC, and then my color that I'm using for my contour is the NW47, and it's really dark because, you know, I'm really dark, so I only did it a little bit just to see what color it was and whatnot. So this is the color that I'm using, and as you can see, it's darker than my color. So underneath the bottom of this is one of these, and I am going to take this, spread it over, and go in right under where I use the concealer and add that much. And put it around the hairline too. Alright, and I'm gonna take this brush right here from BH Cosmetics, I think it's called, and I'm gonna use this one for my nose to contour the highlight that I put right there. And let's see. And then the smaller brush on this part, I don't know, it just seems like it will work better than the bigger sponge that came with the MAC. Okay, so right now I'm going to take this, and I'm just going to make sure it's in there, and I'm going to take my sponge and I'm going to blend it more in. My dog is behind me. Make sure it's blended out, I've heard. Don't look too bad to me, guys. Maybe I should get a darker color to contour with. I don't know, guys. What do you think so far? do you think so far? Okay. So, what do you think, guys? I think I'm well blended now. This thing works miracles. Okay. What do you think? Okay, guys, so that is the contouring. If you want to stop right here, you can, and you know, you can use your foundation, go over the top of it, and then take your whatever primer, well, not primer, but whatever finisher powder you use, you can put it over the top. I use this one by NYX, or you can take your matte finish, you know, long lasting setting spray and set it right after you do this. But for me, my dog is getting everything. For me, I am going to take some of this Illuminizer from Sephora, and I'm just going to highlight a tiny bit more and see what it looks like. So, I just used a tiny bit, and it looks like this. So, it's pretty pearlized. And since I don't have the Ben Nye that I really, really want, I'm just going to take some of this and go over it a little bit. And I make sure I don't add too much, because it'll kind of look, I don't know, it'll kind of look too pearlized finish, and I just want like a little natural thing going on. So that's what it did. So now I can officially take my foundation if I want to, or take my finishing powder and put it on. And I usually use this brush for my finishing powder. So let's go ahead and try some of that. And finish it and set it all up. And I'm not going to put on my, you know, eye makeup or anything. I'm just gonna go out like this. So that's over. It doesn't take much to set your makeup. It doesn't really. And then my matte finish, I'm going to just spray it, and that's it, guys. If you want to do your eye makeup, you can do it at this time. If not, we can head out the door. So thank you guys for coming with me on my first contouring mission. Let me know what you think. To me, it seems like I may need a darker color when it comes to contouring. But then again, I kind of like the way this looks. So you all tell me what you think about this. And again, I used the MAC NW7. The Studio MAC Tech in NW47. So this is the color that I use for contouring today. And again, y'all, thank you. Until next time, P.S. Love you.